Hello, I'd like to talk about standard deviation and variance at this time. We talked about the range last time. Let me read this one. Suppose that a manager wants to test two new training programs. He randomly selects 5 people for each training type and measures the time in minutes. It takes to complete a task after the training. So we have two data sets, okay, training number one method and training number two method, right? So which training method is better, okay? So this data set is in rows, not in column. So let us just type, it's not too much data set, okay? Okay. Share screen and StatCrunch, okay? Okay, so let us type 56 and then 75 and 48 and 63, okay? So I don't wanna do this one and I type here for you, okay? So first column is training number one, second column is training number two, okay? So then, we go to stack, summary stacks, columns. So we've been doing this, right? So we know how to do it. So stack, summary stacks, column. Okay, let's click. Okay. Now let us click this one, training one and two. Okay, drag, then we can highlight at the same time. And we can see variance there, right? I think I spelled wrong in the earlier. variance. And the standard deviation there, right? So let us just compute. It's already there, okay? So let's take a look. We have a same mean, okay? So averaging about the time, right? But then how do you compute? How do you calculate standard deviation? So variance here and standard deviation. So standard deviation always followed by variance, and variance always followed by standard deviation, because the formula, right? One of them is a squared, and one of them square root, right? Okay, so variance, we call the standard deviation, which is S. This is for sample, by the way, okay? So if we say that this is S, then variance is S squared, right? Okay, then look, standard deviation is first training number one is 9.93, and second training, which is training number two, standard deviation is 3.34, right? So this is less spread out. spread out. Okay, so it means that it's a small standard deviation. Okay, small standard deviation is less spread out. Less spread out means more consistent. Okay, larger standard deviation, let me use a different color. Larger standard deviation, okay, is more spread out. Okay, means less consistent, right? Okay, in this case, since they have the same mean, okay, we compare the standard deviation, okay, so training number two is a better method because we can expect the timing, okay? Because more consistent, Why? Because small standard deviation is less spread out, right? Okay. I hope this one helps you. Thank you.